assistant professor in LJ College of Engineering. Welcome to the next session of Principle of Management. In previous session, we discussed the functions of management, but we discussed the first planning and the second staffing. In this session, we will discuss another three functions of the management. Just you will look at these functions: planning, staffing, organizing, directing, and the controlling. Planning and staffing discussed already in the previous session. Let's discuss about organizing, directing, and the controlling one by one. First one is what is organizing. Organization is the process of identifying and the grouping of the works to be performed, defining and delegating responsibility and the authority, and establishing relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most efficiently. This is the definition of organizing. In previous session, we have already discussed the organization structure. This we will go through is that what is organization, what is the nature of organization, and what is the concept of organization. Any organizations work for only two concepts: first, differentiation, and second, integration. What this differentiation says that it means that an organization is composed of units that work on specialized tasks using different work methods and requiring employees with unique competitions. And what is integration? Integration says that the various units must be put back together so that work is coordinated. This is the concept and the purpose of the organization. First, coordinates activities, cluttered job into units. It ensures optimal use of resources, establishes relationship among the individual groups. It facilitates growth, creativity. Then, what is the nature of organization? First, group of persons, common objectives, division of work, cooperative efforts, communication, central authority, rules and regulation, and the dynamic agreement. This is the nature of the organization. Means that of course there is a group of that employees, that goal is must be one common goal like that. Then what is the importance of organization? First, facilitates administration. Second, encourage growth and diversification. Third, optimum use of technology that encourage good human relations, ensures continuity of the enterprise and coordination. These are the importance of the organization. Step of the organization: division of work, grouping of job into the departmentation, assigning duties, establishing authority and the responsibility, delegation of authority, effective communication, and coordinates of activities. And then the different another topic is the structure of organization. We have already discussed that units in the previous session, that what are the different organization structure, like formal, informal, line and staff, and matrix. We have already discussed it. Means for this session, for organization, these topics are sufficient. Next is what is directing. This figure says a lot. Like this is a success, and if we want to go through that success, then we have to follow the directing steps also. This directing can lead to success and a failure. Means if the direction is wrong, then we will go through the wrong steps. And if the direction is right, then we will jump to the success. This meaning, what is the meaning? Direction is a function of management performed by top level management in order to achieve organizational goals. It is very important and necessary functions of management. Management has to undertake various activities like guide people, inspire, lead them, as well as supervision of their activity is required in order to achieve a desired result. Definition. Direction consists of the process and the techniques utilizing issuing instructions and making certain the operations are carried out originally planned. Directing involves the determining the course, giving the orders and instruction and providing dynamic leadership. And what are the functions of the directing? It guides and helps the subordinate to complete the given task properly and as per schedule. It provides the necessary motivation to subordinate to complete the work satisfactorily and strive to do that the best. It helps the maintaining discipline and rewarding those who do well. Directing involves supervision, which is essential to make sure that the work is performed according to the orders and the instruction. These are the functions of the directing. Directing involves telling people what is to be done and explaining how to do it. Issuing instructions and orders to the subordinates, inspiring them to contribute towards the achievement of objectives, supervising their activities and providing leadership and the motivations. What are the components of this process? First, supervision. Second, motivation. Third, leadership. And the fourth one, communication. This is the communication. This is the motivation. This is the leadership. And this is the supervision. We have already discussed about the leadership and motivation. The leadership and motivation is one unit of this your chapter. What is supervision? Supervision is the directing efforts of employee and other resources to accomplish stated work output. Then what is motivation? Motivation is something that moves the person to action and continues him in the course of action already initiated, about to be initiated. Then what is the leadership and the communication? Leadership is essentially a continuous process of that behavior. A leader brings the nerve into the group and motivates it towards the goals. The lookout desire for achievements are the transformed into burning passion for that accomplishment. Then what is the communication? Communication is the transfer of information from one person to another by transmitting ideas, facts, thoughts, feelings and the values. In its absence, organization would cease to exist. These are the directing. Next is the controlling. What is the controlling? This controlling definition. Control is the primary goal-oriented function of management in any organization. It is the process of comparing the actual performance with the set of standards of the company to ensure that activities are performed according to the plan. This is the definition of the control. Next, every manager needs to monitor and evaluate the activities of his subordinates. It helps in taking the corrective action by the managers in the given timeline to avoid any loss of that company. That are the definitions. What are the features? An effective control system has the following features. What are these features? First, it helps in achieve organizational goals. Facilitates the optimum uses of resources. It evaluates the accuracy of the standards. It also sets discipline and order. It evaluates the accuracy of the standard, motivates the employee and bosses employee morale, ensures future planning by revising standards, improve overall performance of an organization. It also minimizes the error. That are the features. And what are the process of that controlling? Step number one, establishment of standards. Step number two, measurement of actual performance. Step number three, comparison of actual performance with the standards. And step number four, correction if necessary. And that feedback is given to that process. That's step number one, process. Establishing standards. This means setting up the target which needs to be achieved to meet organizational goals. Standards indicate the criteria of performance. Control standards are categorized as quantitative and qualitative standards. Quantitative standards express in terms of money, and qualitative standards on the other hand includes the items also. Step number two, measurement and actual performance. The actual performance of the employee is measured against the target. With the increasing level of management, the measurement of performance becomes difficult. Step number 3. Taking corrective action. Comparison of actual performance with the standard. This compares the degree of difference between the actual performance and the standard, and then they have to take actions against that. It is initiated by the manager who corrects any defects in the actual performance. These are the step number 3 and the step number 4. Then what are the advantages of the controlling? First, saves time and energy, allows manager to concentrate on important tasks. This allows better utilization of managerial resources, helps in timely corrective action to be taken by the managers. Manager can delegate tasks, so routinely chores can be completely by the subordinates. These are the advantages of the controlling. Means in this session, we discuss directing, controlling and the organizing. For this session, this point are sufficient. We will meet in the next session. For this session, thank you. Thank you so much.